Awesome. Hi, Ricky.
Hello. Thanks for having me aboard. How are ya?
I'm well. How about yourself?
Not too bad. Not too bad.
Staying
dry. Not trying to stay dry from the weather. The way things are going at the moment, we've constantly had rain for roughly 2 weeks in a row now, every single day. So yeah. So staying in my dry spot at the moment. Trying to stay out of it, keep my little feet nice and dry.
There you go. So I'm going to do something precautionary, and I'm audio recording this too, just in case on my phone.
No, that's fine. Yeah. Do whatever you have to do. I mean, if the worst comes to worst, we can always record again.
No, no more, please.
It's a last strike. It's a last strike. It's number three now.
That time's a charm. We're just going to go with that.
Yeah.
All right. So in keeping the tradition of my brother featuring some artists last year, it was Paula. She's doing fantastic still. So proud of her. And this year, Charlie sent you the questionnaires to be the featured artist. Well, not this year. It was 2020, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Correct. And then we didn't do a featured artist last year due to everything and COVID and all that. But you thankfully kept the questions and had intended to answer them. And so we decided this year to do it on video because we love technology.
Yeah, I do.
And let's just get started. So who are you? What is your name and your company?
My name is Setareki in Quanikawai, but in short firms, it's just Ricky. So, and I'm under the name of Ricky Designs, based here on the south coast of Australia, which is 20 minutes out of Sydney in an area called the Illawarra.
Nice.
And down south, we're actually 2 hours away from Sydney.
Further south and down under.
Yeah, down under, where all the good things are.
And everything wants to kill you.
Yeah, especially kangaroos.
Yeah, they're scary. I don't care how cute they are when they're babies. Nope. Okay, and how long have you been painting?
I have been painting since 2013. But I officially started Ricky Design in 2016. So, and yeah, that's when I just started like painting properly, really started painting for people. It was in 2016.
Okay. And how did you get into painting?
Well, I first started off painting when I went down to my local RC track one day, and just by looking at all the custom painted shells and all the different color schemes that were going on with different people, that's basically what actually got me really started, was trying out painting. Well, I was actually just going to try it out for fun, but here I am doing it seriously. Like, I really did not think that I would be here right now with you talking, having this conversation as a painter. It's just amazing, like, how far it's actually taken me. Yeah. So, and here I am.
Yeah, some wonderful paint jobs. I mean, I think we were talking about it the other day. You put out multiples of the same fantastic artwork, like, every night. It's something different every night. Or every day,
yeah,
for us, every day for you.
Yeah, I mean, it's just basically, you know, like, being creative and just trying out new things. Most of the time I'm painting, like, to be honest with you, Angela, I really have no plan. Like, I just start off with basic lines, and then I just draw lines after that and just add in colors. And next thing you know, like, you come out with some work you're actually surprised with, and, you know, like, it's something you actually didn't plan to do, and you just looking back at it and said, well, did I do that? Yeah, you just did that. And it's basically like a learning curve every day to try something new, you know. I mean, it doesn't hurt, you know. I mean, you got to think out of the box sometimes, you know, and just try and do your own thing. I mean, that's what makes you a better painter or a better artist. I mean, basically, it's art.
It
You know,
is.
painting is art. Yeah, there's no limit. I mean, it's just a never-ending story. You just keep on going and going, and you learn things. I mean, I'm still learning until this day, and I'm not perfect, to be honest. Like, I still do make mega mistakes. You know, like, I just try and forget it and just keep going. Yeah.
Awesome. So that kind of leads us to the next question. What, if any, are you known for?
Well, I'm known for a lot of my work is just pinstripes, lines, and trying out new color combos, but mostly pinstripes. It's something in which I really did take a note to in painting. I took the other way from people doing shadows. Like, a lot of people like to drop shadows, and I just went completely the other way. Like, I wasn't really good at doing shadows, to be honest with you. So I tried a different method of doing pinstripes, and for me, that just worked out really, really good. And I just got the habit of doing pinstripes, and from there, I went into detail work, trying out a bit of, you know, like paint strokes, dots, stencils, and all sorts of different things. So, yeah, so it's just basically pinstripes most of the time. Sometimes it's too crazy. I end up with probably four or five different pinstripes when it was only supposed to be one or two.
Do you not shadow your pinstripes?
Sorry?
Do you not shadow your pinstripes?
I do at times, but it just depends on the designs. I mean, if it does need it, I do add it, but if it does look good enough for me, I just leave it the way it is. And yeah, like, I try not to overkill it, in
Sure.
other words. Yeah, just like keep it simple, as I usually say to people, but
Right.
it does really look simple sometimes. But yeah, it's just, yeah.
All right. And so what kind of, oh, so well, I guess that answers the question of what kind of painting you like to do the most is the pinstripes. That's what you enjoy.
Yes.
Okay. And
Yeah, and
go ahead.
sorry, Angela.
No, sorry, go ahead.
No, you go.
There was nothing else. I mean, there was leading
Ladies
up to
first.
that. Well, I actually have seen you do a couple other different styles. Like you hand painted some flowers a couple weeks back.
Yes, that was a Japanese-based theme, which one of the customers actually did wanted. It actually started off with an Oni mask design, which basically is a Japanese samurai warrior's mask. I think that's what they used to wear back in the day during the samurai
Excellent.
time. I decided to add some cherry blossom flowers, which is actually a Japanese tree, I think, if I'm correct. I'm not
Very
sure. Yep.
common motif in Japanese art is cherry blossoms.
And that took me 3 days to actually paint that on, and most of that artwork was actually hand painted, just
Excellent.
with as you may call it, a pencil paintbrush. Is that correct?
Water brush.
A water brush. That's correct. That's what I'm looking for. Water brush, and just with a fine brush. And yeah, that's basically how I did it, with a bit of color and a bit of help from you guys. Thank you very much. And I was able to achieve it. And it took a lot of time, but it was definitely worth it. I was actually really, really, really surprised. I wanted to keep that for myself, to be
Sure.
honest with you.
Yeah, it was a work of art, and it was, I'm sure it was a nice change from the norm that you normally do.
It is. I mean, Japanese art is basically one of my favorites. I just love doing Japanese designs, Asian designs in general. I do think in general their artwork is just so amazing. I mean, the amount of time and effort they put in, and the patience they have to do it, like, I actually somehow can feel it. Like, that's what it takes, you know. I mean, art is something you can't rush. It takes
Absolutely.
so much time to do what they do, and I really, really do respect them for that. And hopefully I can come up with a few more new ones.
Yeah, hopefully
Yeah.
too. That's some really good stuff that you're putting out, especially the
Thank
creative
you.
stuff. So, So who inspires you when you think of painting?
Well, when I first off started airbrushing properly, I looked up a few videos on the internet, on YouTube and Google, and I came across a site called RC Painting. And the first video I ever saw was Charlie's, your brother. Thank you, Charlie. And just from there, like learning tips and tricks on how to paint, the different paints, the different thinners, the different techniques, and just the basics of painting. And that's what really carried me through, like, and motivated me to paint using an airbrush. And from using spray cans, that's exactly how I started.
Wow.
Yeah, just from a simple video like that. That's so I went to get myself a airbrush, a hose, an air compressor, and all the things basically needed. And that was my kickstart, yeah, for painting. And yeah, it wasn't really a good start for me, to be honest with you.
Okay.
First day with my airbrush, I dropped it. The needle bent. It looked like a fishing hook. And I was actually telling myself, is this actually going to work out for me or not?
Goodness.
But so I just basically picked it up from there and I kept going. But I did not start off properly with an airbrush on my first paint job. It was an actual spray can, in
Okay.
which was a complete disaster on my first RC show, because I painted everything, including the windows. So it looked like a sample of a mold of a body that went wrong. And if I do have that body somewhere around here, I'll make sure to post that up to see, hey, this is Ricky from the beginning. Look at him.
That
Oh,
would be awesome.
yeah, my first paint job ever.
You've definitely
And
come a long way from there.
yes, I have. I have. And Charlie was basically the roots of my foundation of painting RC shells from airbrushing, from that day forth, I kept on looking on his videos, and it was great. I mean, he was so great. His instructions were clear. It was very simple, and it wasn't made for professional people. He did a video so that every person that is actually trying to paint RC would understand him in such a way. And I think, yeah, I mean, everyone literally really loved it, and that's how it all became to be. And here I am.
Yeah, that's so awesome. So, what kind of advice can you give a rookie?
The best advice I can give a rookie, right? Out of 165 things I can give a rookie, the best thing I can tell you guys is just keep painting, keep trying your best to do whatever you can do, learn from the most experienced people, try things your own way. I mean, think out of the box, try new things, like move up as you go along in painting, add new things in your paintwork as you move on. And, just don't try and be anyone else. Just try and be yourself and try your best. That's the best way you can learn. And I mean, we're just here to, like, help you guys. And I mean, if you guys have any questions or anything, just feel free to ask. I mean, that's what RC Paint Chat is here for, sort of
Absolutely.
thing. And like I told you before, Angela, like my dad said, he can only show us the door, but it's up to us. We have to open it. So yeah, I mean, and just keep painting, keep going, guys. Yeah, don't hold back. The sky's not the limit, it's beyond that. Just keep going for it. Yeah.
I'm really glad you didn't give up on painting, from cans to, because you wouldn't be where you are now if you had given up. So that's the best advice you could really give anybody. That's wonderful.
Yeah, I mean, like everyone has to start somewhere. Like in this industry we're in at the moment. I mean, I started off with paint cans because back then, I mean, the most common things in which people actually did use was cans. I mean, not really a lot of people knew about airbrushing, especially here in Australia. There was only a few guys actually doing it at the moment. apart from me and Ben, Mr. Ben was actually one of the first RC painters here in Australia, and I think he stopped for a fair few good years. He had a massive break from painting, and like I literally could not find a lot of other painters here in this country apart from James Ansell, and there was a few other more painters. So the only thing I did start off with was just by using cans until I actually decided to look up the internet and try airbrushing, and I just changed my whole game, just changed from there sort of thing, and I haven't used any cans probably for the last 10 years, I think.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just everything runs through the airbrush now. Yeah, and it's great. It's great. I mean, people still use cans these days for painting, but I think they mostly use it in spraying large areas
Sure.
of bodies, or if they want a really, really quick paint job. But airbrush is the way to go.
It's
It's
definitely
definitely the
different.
way. It's definitely is.
It's I'm completely new to it. I've been doing it for maybe a month, 2 months now, I think. I'm not religious like most people are because I have other crafts that I do, but
Yes.
it's super exciting to get into, especially having all the supplies at my fingertips because of my brother. But it's really humbling too to be able to get all the support from like all of you guys, all the admins and the mods and everybody in RC Paint Chat. It's a great community that my brother built, and we are all
Oh,
so
yes.
better for it, you know?
Yes, definitely. Charlie has built a great community for RC painting, and you've got really, really, really big shoes to fill in,
I
Angela.
do.
You don't worry. Like you said,
No pressure.
you've got no pressure. Oh yeah, take your time.
Well, he had 20
And
years of airbrushing anyway, so.
I mean, you've got a lot of help. You've got a lot of support. And the good thing about you and where you're from is that you've got like some of the best RC painters in the world, and you've got Dave from Coastal Airbrush, which has been helping you so much. He is such a great person, and
Absolutely.
thank you, Dave, for all the great colors. Wicked colors all the way. Woohoo!
Yeah, all the way. And all the live at fives. I stumbled upon a couple of them that, well, actually I searched out all of them that my brother was in. So I've watched, I think, almost all of them now at this point, 'cause they're long, but they're so valuable.
Oh yes, it's basically a Bible. I mean, I've also got a few of those great videos. I mean, learning how to use colors, and the procedures, the guns, the equipment, and everything is so much explained, in the most simplest way, and it's so great. Yeah, it's just so great, like to treasure those tips and videos, because it's a Bible verse.
It really
It's
is. We're all better painters, artists for it, so.
And Angela, wish you all the best, and I think a lot of us are so happy to see you, taking those footsteps in reach and continuing RC Paint Chat with the admin, and I've like trying to keep this page going, in memory of Charlie, and to carry on the great work he's left for every person, every single one of us, and and we shall basically just carry on his great work and just keep on going, and hopefully, keep on going and going and going.
Forever, yeah. Art is
Yeah,
forever. And
forever.
so when I just really loved all the love that people have been giving me. And I don't want this to be about me. I should stop. But for sure, RC Paint Chat forever. It's a great group, and I'm thankful for all the support and all the great painters that are out there. We want to continue it, and we want to make sure that everybody is given a fair chance to be able to paint. And we watch out for those who try to screw you guys over. We don't want any of that. And you know, we don't want anybody really to be discouraged. I know that it happens to the best of us. It's a lot of it is
Yeah.
because of the customers. But you know, it's not just, it feels like it's not just like just for learning how to paint, but it's also support for your paint business. And
Yeah,
that's a wonderful thing.
yeah. I mean, you know, and also the other thing. I mean, the reason why the site is there, like I said before, is to help people. It's not a site in which is there for people who are looking for painters or people who are trying to sell paintwork or sell stuff. You know, it's not about that. That's why it's called RC Paint Chat. Yeah. So, you know, and like, yeah. I mean, you know, like to inspire and to help people. I mean, yeah, and we can just have to keep on continuing that and ask as many questions as you people may can ask. I mean, it doesn't matter if the question is so dumb, I'll still try my best to answer it. And it's, yeah, I mean, repeated questions is not, it's not a bad thing. I mean, it's something that will always help happen, but we're there to help, so we'll try and just keep on answering the questions to whatever the best we can to.
Absolutely. That's what the community is all about.
Exactly. Right. Yeah. So, yeah, Angie, I mean, you're a good example to those people who are learning, trying to get into the business, or I mean, not to the business, you know, to painting RC. I mean, you know, like you've got to start from somewhere. Like you've got all the help, you've got all the support, and just keep trying. And yeah,
Absolutely.
that's what we're here for, guys.
So, you guys are fantastic painters. We're so blessed to have you guys, and all the other wonderful painters out there. Just great community. Just keep on painting, just like you said, and practice. Practice, practice, practice.
Practice is the main key for, like, it's the one of the main elements. I mean, you know, if I mean, if you don't practice, if you don't think out of the box, if you don't try new things, you'll never learn. You know, you'll never pick up as much as you want to pick up. So you just need to, yeah, practice. I mean, most of the time, that's what I put down on the post. Practice. Just
Absolutely.
practice. Practice makes perfect. Trust me, it works.
You would know
It works.
from painting a whole
Yeah.
wall one color to you know painting with a water brush. That's I still can't get over that. That's just fantastic.
It's also hard work, you know, like I've had
Fell,
Oh.
but it's still alive. I think we're still good. We're still recording.
Yeah.
Yeah,
No, that's fine. Is the laptop okay?
it's, I mean, it survived. My hat fell into the water. Can you grab that, Lily? Can you fish it out? Yeah, we had a super strong gust of wind.
Another something I wanted to point out is to please, for you guys out there, is to support your local hobby shops, you know, I mean,
Absolutely.
your local paint supplies and your hobby shops as well. I mean, I think there's a few places out there which are actually struggling at the moment as well, especially in RC. So, you know, like buying paints or liquid masks or airbrushes or just simple things like that really does help them out. Thank you.
Definitely. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
That's what keeps us all being able to do what we do is if we support the
Yes.
community, not only the painters, but also the suppliers. That's super important. Thank you for that.
Yeah, that's yeah, you know, like, you know, everyone of these places need to make a dollar. I mean, it's been hard for everyone for the last few years, so just try your best and support them in the best way in which you can. And
Absolutely.
it does, you know, it does play, I mean, you know, a major role in the industry we're in, sort of speaking. Yeah. And yeah, so RC Paint Chat, guys, you guys are all fantastic. Thank you so much throughout the years for your help, your support, the smart comments, the dumb comments, all sorts of
All of
comments
them.
in which
All of
everyone
them.
has made. I mean, you know, sometimes on this page everyone has a good moment. Sometimes we all have a bad moments, but it's always a great page, you know, like getting to meet people around the world. different painters around the world, different designs, color schemes, learning from one another. And yeah, thank you so much, guys. It's awesome. It's been so
Awesome.
great. Yeah. So, and
Thank you
just
so
hope
much,
like
Rishi.
every.
That was
Yeah, no worries.
it's getting really
Yeah.
windy here, and I have a tent up and it's about to fly away. So Lily's actually helping me hold it down, which is why my arm is up
Oh,
here.
hi, Lily.
He says hi.
Hey. Okay, well, wrap it up.
Yeah,
Go
we'll wrap
smoke
it
a
up.
stick.
Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for doing this a third time. And
That's okay. I mean, if it doesn't work, we'll do it
no, I don't want
again.
to do
If,
it
if well, if you don't want to do it again, you see that swimming pool behind you?
again. Yeah.
Yeah,
I'll throw the laptop in there if it doesn't record, for crying out loud.
if it doesn't work, next time said, just tell Ben, I've given up. It's your turn now,
There you
Ben.
go. Yeah, because he's the tech guy anyway.
Yeah, he can start interviewing Max for change.
That'll be, oh my God, I can
Yeah.
only imagine what that conversation would be like.
Oh, Max would like, well, what's the next question?
It's
Should
gonna be
be
great.
great.
I
Okay,
think
thank you very much, wishes.
we should make that a thing. I think we need to make that happen.
Yeah, and hopefully one day soon in the near future, like all of us guys can meet up somewhere. And you know, like in person, that would be awesome.
So awesome. Let's make that
Yeah,
happen in Fiji.
like, oh, in Fiji would be great. America, Australia, anywhere.
Italy.
Yeah, Italy. Yeah,
Yeah.
as long as we don't ask people in Italy to have a pizza with pineapple, we're fine.
I'm not saying anything. No comment. I like pineapples in my pizza. All right, Ricky. I'm gonna
Okay.
go ahead and cruise your website to for any pictures that I'll post along with this, just to show off your artwork. And yeah, thanks for your time. I
No.
appreciate it.
That's fine. Go for it and see how we go. Okay,
Right, mate.
all right,
Have a
Angela,
good
take
one.
care.
Okay.
I'll speak to you later. See
All
ya.
right, cool.
Bye.
Bye.